I am going to give you 6 ideas that will stop your struggle with the GMAT and help you get to your target score faster. And we are getting started right now. The first idea I have for you is this: understand the real objective of the GMAT. A lot of people tend to think of the GMAT as just another math or verbal test. The problem with that paradigm is that it will focus all your attention in just learning the concepts, the formulae, or the grammar that you need to do well, or rather solve those problems. The way I look at it, GMAT is actually testing your aptitude to be a good manager. And the point is, being a good manager does not just require math and English skills, but a lot of things beyond that as well. So little things such as your ability to manage time, pressure, trade-offs, and so on and so forth become very, very important and deserve your full attention if you want to maximize your score on the test. The second idea I have for you is that you need to stop using shortcuts and use the real stuff instead. Learn the real stuff, learn the real concepts, learn the proper way to solve problems instead of relying on like random shortcuts to get to the answer quickly. Before I came to Columbia Business School last year, I used to tutor students for the GMAT. And one of the things I've noticed is that people who use shortcuts end up taking more time solving a problem compared to people who just use the right way to solve it. So for example, if you use shortcuts to solve math questions, you might end up taking 5 minutes if you were using those so-called shortcuts, while a person who knows the exact right way to solve it might be able to solve it in under a minute. And that is something which actually gives you a dual advantage, because knowing the right way to do things also actually helps you long term, both at business school and in your business career after your MBA. The other thing to know is that GMAT as a test has been around literally for decades, and test creators have seen hundreds and thousands of students use different approaches to get a high score on the test. So if you think you're going to be able to use shortcuts as an individual and fool the test creators into giving you a high score, you're certainly wrong. Instead, invest your time and effort and attention into learning the right way to do things. It might be slow initially, but as you keep repeating it over time, repeatedly applying it to problems over time, you'll actually get fast enough that it will be faster than any shortcut that you could be using. The third idea I have for you is that you need to outthink your competition exhaustively. And this also connects back to one of the earlier ideas I was speaking about. GMAT is not just about intelligence. It is also about a bunch of other things, like your ability to pre-plan your approach to the test. Little details begin to matter when you're under severe time pressure. How are you going to manage your scratch pad in the exam? Do you even know that the scratch pad that you get in the examination center is not the normal pen and paper that you would be using at home? And that is something that, you know, a lot of people actually get phased about during the test because they just did not expect, they did not know what to expect in the exam. The second thing that is actually ignored by most people that I've met, like literally 95% of test takers that I know, is the aspect of managing your psychological state or your emotional state during the exam. And this is something where even people who are really, really smart otherwise actually lose out on getting a high score. I know people who are recognized as some of the smartest people in their respective countries, but just because they thought that GMAT was a pure test of smarts, these people ended up getting scores of like 730 or 740 despite giving the test multiple times. When I talk about psychological state, what I'm referring to is your ability to manage your emotions during the course of the exam. There are many things that could go wrong, and your ability to stay calm and stay focused is going to be a key competitive edge when it comes to the GMAT. The next idea that you need to know is that you need to manage time and trade-offs intelligently. As you might already know, GMAT is a computer adaptive test. And the biggest implication of that is that not every question is worth the same value. The first question and the 17th question, for example, might have very different impacts on your final score. And that is why you need to be intelligent about ensuring that you manage time and trade-offs effectively. Trade-offs involve little things like, at what point of time do you start guessing at questions? Some people use the approach of spending all of their time solving the first set of questions on the GMAT and then literally guess all the remaining questions in the last minute. Now, is that an intelligent strategy? I don't think so. The thing is, you need to be very proactive when you're managing time during the test. And you have to ensure that you're strategic even with little things like when to start guessing answers for questions. The fifth idea is that you need to have and test a plan B before you need it. Lots of things can go wrong during the exam. What if you start feeling too nervous? What if you start taking more time on questions than you originally expected? What if there is random noise in the test center? I kid you not, during my GMAT exam in 2018, there was some kind of renovation work happening in the building or in the room next door to the test center. And in the middle of my verbal examination, somebody started hammering on the wall. Can you even imagine the kind of distraction that would have caused anybody taking the test at the time? How do you manage your emotions? How do you manage your mental state at a point like that and ensure that you stay focused and are able to continue doing well at the exam instead of getting distracted or frustrated by everything around you that is not in your control? That is something that you need to think of beforehand instead of thinking about it on the spot. The final idea, which is very, very important, is that you need to give the GMAT once, give it right, and move on. There are people who take pride in giving the GMAT several times, like literally 6 times, 7 times, or what have you, to get to their target score. Now, I think that pride is misplaced. Giving the GMAT over and over again is not really a sign of persistence. I think it is a sign of just not planning well. Every time you take the test, you're going to have to pay $250 just for the test fees. In addition to the $250, you're going to take on a lot of stress in preparing for the exam again, while at the same time, there will be a lot of opportunity cost. You could have spent all of that preparation time instead working on a project at your office or doing something else in your life that is worthwhile. Now, instead of doing all of those things, you decided to give the test 7 times and just wasted all of your time and money in the process. Instead, what I recommend is that you plan forward, be very clear about the target score and the kind of effort that you're likely to need. Ensure that you take whatever help you need. If you need to find a tutor, get a tutor. If you need to go online and get a bunch of books, get a bunch of books. If you need advice from a current B-School students, reach out to them. If you have friends who gave the GMAT before, why don't you ask them for advice? These are all things that you should do proactively instead of giving the test over and over again and wasting time on something that is not going to give you much of an upside in the long run. You're much better off spending all of that time preparing for your B-School essays or just doing a project that you can talk about in your essays. So those were really the 6 ideas that I wanted to share with you today. If you like the video, hit the like button. And if you have any questions for me, remember to drop a comment below and I'll make sure that I get back to you within 48 hours. Thank you for watching and see you soon.